Up to this point, our display doesn't tell us much aside from where our well pad is located. So let's start adding data about the oil wells that are located at this well pad. Return to the asset tree on the left and drill down into the oil well production database, past the North Dakota and Crosby elements. Now we see all of our Crosby wells listed out, well 08, well 25, and well 46. Select well 08 and verify the value symbol is selected. Then find the well name attribute and drag it onto the display. Like before, we just want to display the name of this well so we can format the symbol to hide its label, engineering units, and timestamp. When that's finished, copy and paste the symbol two times using either the on-screen copy and paste buttons in the toolbar or the conventional keyboard shortcuts. Next, find well 08's status message attribute and drag it onto the first copy of the value symbol you pasted. All we've done is replace the data item this symbol represents, but by copying it from the original well name symbol, we can retain the changes we've made to hide certain aspects of the symbol. Lastly, find the average 30-day downtime attribute and drag it onto the third value symbol. Because the 30-day average downtime is going to be a numerical value, we can't expect colleagues of ours to know what this value represents based on the number alone. So let's unhide some of the contextual items associated with the value, such as the units and the label. We already have a symbol for the well name, so for the label, let's use the dropdown to display only the attribute name, like so. Our display wouldn't be complete without representation of our primary KPI, oil production. So let's copy and paste downtime symbol and then drag and drop the production rate attribute on top of it. Since this symbol is already configured with the correct label and units, there's no additional work for us to do. Let's clean up this group of symbols by selecting all of them and aligning them horizontally. We can select all of the symbols by drawing a selection box around them or by holding Ctrl and clicking on each one in turn. Once they're all selected, we can use the Align Left option from the Arrange drop-down menu and then right-click on any of the individual symbols and group them together with the Group Symbols option. This will help keep them together and allow us to move them around as one cohesive unit. Lastly, right-click on any of the symbols and select Format Symbols and increase the font size to 14. As a finishing touch, let's reintroduce the oil well graphic from the previous display. Open up the graphic library and expand the plant facilities section. Then select the oil well graphic and draw it next to our stacked value symbols.